Growth complaints are very common, particularly in pediatrics. Short or tall stature can represent benign variation or can be an important clue to diagnosing a disease. A careful history and physical and the use of growth charts can usually distinguish the pathologic causes. Short stature is defined as height 2 standard deviations below the mean. We will look at 4 different growth patterns and see if they represent physiologic or pathologic short stature. The first pattern shows familial short stature, where the child's growth curve is at the low end of the chart, but it's tracking appropriately toward their mid-parental height. This represents a physiologic cause of short stature. This second pattern shows another physiologic cause of short stature, constitutional delay of growth. This is when a child's growth curve decreases during adolescence before exhibiting catch-up growth later. Constitutional delay of growth can run in families, and parents often report being late bloomers. A bone age X-ray can aid in determining a patient's future growth potential. The third pattern shows pathologic short stature beginning prenatally, and this is a pathologic form of short stature that requires investigation. Short stature that begins prenatally can have causes including a genetic or chromosomal disorder such as trisomy 21, or can result from intrauterine growth restriction due to infection, toxin exposure, or metabolic disease. The fourth pattern shows growth failure, or postnatal onset of pathologic short stature. This child's short stature is pathologic due to the crossing of percentile curves. Causes of growth failure include growth hormone deficiency, Turner syndrome, nutrient deficiency, celiac disease, or the effects of chronic diseases such as cystic fibrosis. Tall stature is defined as height greater than 2 standard deviations above the mean. Most commonly, this is due to familial tall stature, and the growth curve should be concordant with the mid-parental height. The pathologic causes of tall stature often have features seen on physical exam. In Marfan syndrome, the patient may have arachnodactyly, pectus deformity, or hyperflexible joints. Patients with growth hormone excess can have coarse features, enlargement of the jaw, hands, and feet, and skin tags.